I'm having an emergency. Mark, there's two MVOs coming on, both in the same vehicle. One's agitated and doesn't want to be here.
Trauma one, trauma two?
Yep, trauma one, trauma two.
The director of emergency, Dr. Mark Putland, is getting details about a high-speed car crash involving two victims about to arrive under police guard.
Five police is a lot of police.
Road accidents are the single biggest cause of major traumas at the Royal Melbourne Hospital.
Police and ambulance are coming with some motor vehicle accident victims. No seatbelts, not being very cooperative, hence police are helping out.
It does start to paint a certain picture. We're always on our guard a little bit. We're a little bit more cautious, but we try to take a fresh start with each person.
The driver of the car arrives first and is rushed into trauma one in a critical condition.
Do not lift your head up. Do not.
He's been in a high-speed MVA. The area that really is complaining of pain is in the right side of his neck and his lower abdomen.
The team needs to move quickly to find any potentially fatal internal injuries and bleeding.
I'm going to have a little look at your tummy with the ultrasound, all right? At the speed that you tend to stop, things can kind of tear.
His blood pressure's low, his heart rate's high. We find evidence of bleeding in his abdomen.
Dr. Mark's also on alert for the second victim, who is the passenger in the car that crashed head-on into a stationary truck. He's highly agitated, and the situation is potentially volatile.
It could be a head injury at 90 kilometres an hour head on into another car, and being a bit uncooperative, anything's possible. Helps that he's coming with police. They come in and they've got him under control, and it takes that pressure off us a little bit. Come on in.
The man has been disruptive and uncooperative with the paramedics and acting very strangely.
Yeah, get on, mate. There's a man right there. Get on there.
Just wriggle over here.
Thank you, mate.
Good chap, good chap. Nearly there, nearly there. Oh, that's the way. Okay, okay. Wrong side up. Roll over the other side. Hey, good man. All right, geez, you've had a rough day. All right.
Yeah, you can say that, mate.
My name's Mark, I'm one of the doctors.
Nice to meet you, mate.
What has happened to you today? Oh, don't wriggle around too much, because you're in the Royal Melbourne Hospital.
Why?
Because you had a crash.
Did I really?
Is the rear passenger unrestrained of a sedan hitting a truck? Left shoulder pain.
Just leave your head back.
He's quite uncooperative and is almost on the nod as if he's affected by heroin or another drug. He has denied any alcohol or drug intoxication. I was unable to get him to comply with a collar or any other spinal precautions.
It's not aggro with you, just wriggling.
Correct. Uncooperative is a good word. There was no aggression.
If I need to put a collar on you, is that okay?
No, I don't want a collar. I'm not a dog.
The team must take the man's clothes off to examine him properly, but he seems reluctant.
You got a right to be a goose in a way. Like, if people are allowed to be stupid, but if the reason they're being a goose is because they're really, really sick, or if it's just they're a goose, so it's a delicate balance. Hey, lie down. Go back to sleep.
For some unknown reason, the man continues to resist having his clothes removed. Behaviour that's making Mark suspicious.
Keep your head still. You're covered.
Hey, lie down.
Down the corridor, Dr. Mark Putland has a double trauma on his hands, with two victims being treated in separate rooms after a high-speed car crash into a stationary truck. In Trauma Bay 1, the driver is in a critical condition with massive internal bleeding. Next door in Trauma 2, his mate and passenger in the car is behaving strangely, and Dr. Mark's trying to understand why.
Hey, what have you had this morning? You don't look like your normal self.
You don't know me.
What drugs have you had?
So for my patient, it doesn't seem like he's bleeding. His mental state has been peculiar and is now becoming sedated. Our concern really is to rule out a serious head injury.
What have you had? Are you grog or something else?
Why are you holding my head?
So that you don't...
Move your neck around, because you don't know if you've broken. OK, I'm just going to take a quick ultrasound of your belly.
Try and uncover every part of him, make sure he's OK.
You're covered.
Yeah, we'll keep your blanket over your cods, OK?
With the patient continuing to resist having his jeans and underwear removed, Dr. Mark's suspicions grow.
You got anything valuable in your jeans pocket?
So he decides to check inside the man's underwear to find the cause.
Look at that.
Just pulled his jocks down to have a look, make sure there wasn't a big bleeding or bruising around his scrotum that can go with a pelvic fracture. As I'm uncovering him, I've found something in his underwear that starts to make sense of his behaviour.
Dr. Mark has found suspected illegal drugs in the man's underpants.
OK. So don't wash your hands with that hand gel, because I suspect it's... I suspect it's not. Well, hand gel's often not hand gel when it's kept in the underpants of people who also store bags of white powder in their underpants. Well, it explains why he's a bit peculiar today.
Next door in Trauma One, the other victim involved in the high-speed car crash is seriously injured.
Do you still feel like you're going to be sick?
A little bit, yeah.
An ultrasound has found more than a litre of blood in the driver's abdomen from a torn bowel. As he's prepared for urgent surgery, the police get to work gathering evidence on his mate next door.
His undies. No track marks anywhere.
That's all right. Mate, have you got any needles on you? Okay, all right. Just want to make sure everyone's safe.
In this type of case, the hospital is required to provide police with the patient's blood results after a motor vehicle crash.
So we've got this tricky balance. I don't want people afraid to come to hospital. Everyone should be able to come and get taken care of.
As the driver is taken for emergency surgery to repair his torn bowel, the passenger is taken to the CT scanner to check for any internal injuries.
Please breathe in and hold your breath.
He's escaped the car accident relatively unscathed.
It's remarkable what people are able to get away with sometimes. This was, by the sounds of it, a pretty decent speed and a decent impact, and they've managed to get away with it, which is dumb luck, I suppose.